Hello guys, welcome to Global Online University, and now we are going to discuss about some of other questions which not discussed in previous videos. Now you can see first question where this coupling reaction and followed by reduction and then acylation in presence of acetic anhydride. You can see this where so easy question. You can see olefin will always couple with iodine in presence of palladium acid. This is a coupling reaction, you can see. So we will get it here, carbazole like indole type derivative, and then reduction of cyanide to give us amine, and then they have given acetic anhydride also to acylate the nitrogen. So this will be the correct answer. You can see first A and B, they were asked in question like question paper, so you can see these are the answers, right? We'll move to second questions. So you can see here copper reagents always will give Michael addition, and when the enolate will come back, which will trapped by the electrophile, and here now pH selenium bromide bromide is electrophile here. So this will be the answer for this one. And in presence of oxidizing agent, that selenium will oxidize, and then elimination of that selenium to get this product, right? So we can see next question where this is a question depend on the oxidation. Now you can see PCC is an oxidizing agent where alcohol will be oxidized and to form aldehyde, and then in presence of Lewis acid, that olefin there is a allylic rearrangement where proton shift and then rearrangement with the aldehyde, and then cyclization with aldehyde to get this carbon type derivatives, right? This is the correct answer for that question. So you can see for the next question, they have asked about 1H NMR signals. You can see they have I have labeled each and every carbon like protons. So there will be a 5 different asymmetric protons which will be appear in 1H. So this 5 answer will be there. This is a like a numerical type question, so 5 will be the correct answer for this one. So next question, where pyridine N oxide, you know this concept where whenever N oxide is there, that N oxide will activate the position at CH3 and the acylation will occur at the CH3 position. You can see here I have given question, that answer I have given where acylation has happened, right guys? These are the questions I have solved in this video. You can see whole question.